This is Peak Channel Television News.
The owners and drivers of the 6 trucks in the Apapa area of Lagos on Wednesday, July 1st, 2020, embarked on a peaceful demonstration to protest their disapproval of the arbitrary extortion of money by members of the Federal Tax Force and the Lagos State Police Command Tax Force. The demonstration, which had the placard-carrying owners and drivers of the 6 trucks march back and forth from the Folau jetty to the Apapa port and down to the Tinkan Island port first gate, all in the Apapa area, also had them chanting and yelling their disapproval. The leader of the group, Chief Anthony Agbanosi, poured out their feelings this way.
Now, if you enter ferry from Maitu, it takes you only 3 hours to get to Apapa here. 3 hours only instead of 6 weeks. And we are paying, as we are dropping here, we pay 28,000 again for the settlement to all the security along the road. So all these things, because we did not pass through their road, they said that this route is illegal. On 1st of June, all the vehicles that were brought through Ibru Jetty, the chairman of task force went and locked the gate for almost 2 weeks. Then on the 1st of June, he connived with a Lasma towing vehicle, illegal towing. In the midnight with hoodlums, they come and drag the driver down and drove 100 beat drivers and drove the vehicle, spoiling the vehicle, towing some to Ijora, Costain, and Orile, by collecting 200,000 from truck owners. And that 200,000 naira have no receipt. That's why we said the Lagos State Government is not doing what it's supposed to do. They lose their voice to the former Commissioner of Transport Lagos State, Mr. Peifa, who almost killed us when he was the Commissioner of Transport Lagos State. Now, this money they are collecting should be accounted for. We have some receipts here, which they give us. Receipt read AA High Tech. My boys went and paid. The other one, all the receipts are here. So all the one we paid, 200 vehicles that they towed to each other, about 10 are still remaining. The owner has no money. They said they will keep them there for 3 months to punish them. See, as I'm talking to you now, yesterday evening at Ijora Bridge, they went and towed 11 vehicles belonging to NATO for nothing's sake, because they did not come through their nose. Now they say they should go and pay to last man. So what they're saying is that all the vehicles they towed from Ibru Jetty, 200,000 times 200 vehicles, to whose purse the money? Because there's no receipt. We obey them. They say we are fools. We don't know our rights. Now we want to tell the world that we know. We want government to disband the task force and to make this ferry movement legal until when the road is repaired. With the condition of the road now, we remain on the road for 3 months without getting to Tinkam. But with ferry now, under 3 hours, we are in Tinkam. And they don't allow us to move in their time. And we accepted it.
Also speaking, deputy leader of the group and a truck owner, Stephen Akinwumi, shared his disapproval of the extortion.
500 workers lock up their equipment for the past 3 weeks and they are unable to go in and they are unable to go out. Please. As of today, three of our vehicles, our company vehicles, are locked down here. And when we want to enter Fano today, they didn't open the gate early. The very vehicle that was about to enter, Lagos State Task Force came to the place and tore about 10 vehicles away to their office today. So we are calling on the government. The harassment, the embarrassment, and the intimidation of workers, particularly truck owners, those of us that are carrying containerized cargoes, enough is enough. Before we take the laws into our hand, we are asking the government of Federal Republic of Nigeria and the government of Lagos State to come to our rescue.
Other affected members also showed their displeasure as they lamented the oppressive attitudes of the task force team.
There is no road. The government is repairing the road. The roads are bad and government are trying. Then for us to discongest this road, we managed to use bus to make it easy for ourselves to join through Maitu to this place, which we pay a very good sum amount, up to 170,000 naira for a trip. A trip that would have taken us on the road, it would take us 2 to 3 weeks. But we After Sundays, we stay, we enter batch, we come here for about within 4 hours, we stop. We are unfortunate to us. 1st of June, there is a terminal at Liverpool in this type of occasion. Their vehicles was locked like this, and at a stage, they begin to tow the vehicle, and the owners went and paid some amount to get to collect their vehicle, either from last mile, I don't know. But to my greatest surprise, this that concerns us that are here today. Our vehicle, more than 400 trucks are here. And somebody, a Nigerian, a citizen of this country, after our effort, struggling to make our means ends, lock us for the past 2 weeks now. And there is nowhere for us, with families. Look at us, envisage us, and see how we look like.
Another problem we are having is this. In this Apapa, Lasma are not supposed to be towing vehicles because there are no roads. No road. Where do you want them to go? You come and tow vehicles. Vehicles that are on the line to enter the port. It's not as if they are parking. They are not parking. They are not causing obstruction. You go there, you tow them. And when you tow them to your offices, you charge them 250,000 naira per truck. Without receipt.
We don't really know what is happening, but they say tax force locked up this place. That the business, the badging business is illegal. And we know it's legalized all over the world. So we don't see any reason why they should lock up this place. According to the people that own this particular exit point, they said they are demanding for something which they can't provide for them. So we just plead with the government that, although even the badging system itself, it helps the congestion of the road.
Yes.
It helps a lot of things. You as at yesterday, they first they go to Fagbem's Doba area, you see a lot of trailers. But the time we were operating, trailers were not as much as it was there. And according to what I heard, they said all those tax force people, they are collecting 170,000 naira per trailer before you can get to Tinka, before they can clear you off. But because they no longer see people on the road, I know that is why they have to come and close this place. So if this place is illegal, they should tell us why it's illegal and what are the illegality on it. Okay. They should just get the place open, let people do their job. And it's even causing a lot of congestion on the road. This badging system has helped a lot of Nigerians in Lagos.
So along the line, we'll find out that there's a place that you can be able to be passing to go to work, because we drivers, we don't take salary. Accept the motor work before we have money. So now we are pleading to the federal government to assist us to do the road first. And this ferry, this badge that we use from Maitu to this place, that they will allow us to be going out freely till they finish the road.
The owners and drivers of the six trucks in the Apapa Axis are threatening court action against the tax force and the Lagos state government any moment from now for delaying their vehicles for 30 days without reasons. Greg Odua Abrahams, Peak Channel Television.
This is Peak Channel Television.